The Madonna of Chancellor Rollin by Jan van Eyck is a painting full of spectacular details. But let's start with the basics first. Situated in a Roman-style palace, we can see a meeting of the commissioner of this painting, Nicolas Rollin, who is kneeling down in front of the Virgin Mary, who has baby Jesus on her lap. Rollin's hands are folded in prayer, and he has an open book on his lap. He does not seem to look at Mary and Jesus. On the right side, we see Mary wearing a red gown decorated with jewelry, and she looks down in humility. Baby Jesus, on the other hand, raises his right hand to bless Rollin, and in his left hand he holds a so-called Globus Crucigar, which is an orb with a cross. Above Mary, an angel with rainbow-colored wings holds a crown. The angel is going to crown Mary as the Queen of Heaven, a pretty popular theme in Catholicism and Catholic art. Rollin was the successful Chancellor of Burgundy under Duke Philip the Good, and he commissioned this work for his family's chapel in the Notre Dame du Châtel church in Autun, near Dijon, France. The meeting between Rollin and the Virgin Mary is situated in a beautiful Roman-style palace-like building on top of a hill with a view of the world in the background. There is a city on the left, a river and bridge in the middle, and several church towers on the right, above the head of Jesus. This painting is on display in the Louvre, and if you are an average visitor, you may have gone through the museum admiring large masterpieces like The Wedding at Cana by Paolo Veronese and Liberty Leading the People by Delacroix. And then, near the end of your visit, you may come across this work. It's small in comparison, measuring 62 by 62 centimeters or 26 by 24 inches. I wouldn't blame you if you would just walk past it. But then, if you would stand in front of it, you would see how much detail there is in such a small painting. And while I show you some of the incredible details, it is good to know that Van Eyck painted this around 1435, and that he had learned artistic skills during a time when miniature art was still quite popular in Northern Europe. The difference with earlier miniature artists is that Van Eyck painted his details in a very naturalistic way. And he used oil paint, which made it easier for him to paint each detail to perfection. The painting is full of symbolism. Van Eyck did not include three peacocks in the back because it was his favorite animal. Instead, each element has an important meaning. In the case of the peacock, it is a symbol of immortality. But let's start with the easy ones. The cross that Jesus holds in his left hand reminds the viewers that Jesus died for the sins of mankind. The three arches in the middle background represent the Holy Trinity, God, Jesus, and the Holy Spirit. The flowers symbolize different virtues of Mary. White lilies symbolize purity. Peonies refer to paradise, a rose to Jesus' suffering, irises to the pain of Mary, and daisies symbolize innocence. And the two herons here are a symbol of death. And then there's the background of the painting. Behind the praying hands of Rollin is a church tower to symbolize his fate. The church tower behind Jesus signifies him as the center of the church, and the bridge unites the common people and the church. And it is not a coincidence that the bridge has seven arches. Some people have identified the city in the background as New Jerusalem, but others are not so sure about this interpretation. Let me know in the comments below what you think. There are many wonderful details in this work, and I would like to highlight one of them in particular. The capitals above the head of Rollin contain some very interesting details. From left to right, it shows the following scenes: the expulsion of Adam and Eve from paradise, their son Cain killing Abel, and the drunkenness of Noah with the ark above him. And then on the right side of the painting, partially hidden behind the crown of Mary is a scene about Abraham and Melchizedek. For reference, each of these scenes measures about 1 by 1 inch, which is 2.5 by 2.5 centimeters. And as a true artist, Van Eyck seems to have freely interpreted these biblical stories as he altered some of the details. For example, to the right of Noah, 4 men are depicted. These men should represent the sons of Noah. However, Noah only had 3 sons. It seems likely that Van Eyck has altered these scenes to draw some parallels with Rolin's life. Rolin, for example, had 4 sons, and each of the sons of Noah seems to represent the different roles of the sons of Nicolas Rolin. There is much more to discover in this painting, and in the description box below I leave a link to a cool online project called Closer to Van Eyck. They basically allow you to zoom in as much as you want at the details in this painting. You can, for example, see the small lion heads in these capitals above Rolin's head. Some people interpret these as symbols of anger. And there seem to be some tiny, squashed rabbits at the bottom of the columns, which may be a symbol for lust. And like this, you could scroll through the details in this painting to look at all the details and try to figure out what each of them represents. Let me know what other details you like in this painting. Well, I hope you enjoyed this discussion. If you like the work of Jan van Eyck, you may also enjoy a short video I made about the Arnolfini portrait in the National Gallery in London. And if you want to help out the channel, please consider hitting the thumbs up button, subscribe, and hit the notification bell to be alerted when new videos are released. Thanks for watching.